My name is Dr. Chris Hausler. I'm an infectious diseases physician and the chief of the Office of Public Health and Epidemiology here at the Durham VA. My dad spent 32 years in the Army. He was a West Point grad, graduated in 1968. All through high school, that was my goal, get into West Point, become an Army officer. And so I graduated high school in 2003, started at West Point then, graduated in 2007. And I'd always intended to be an Army officer, but you know, life happens. I have a neuropathy that runs in my family that was diagnosed while I was at West Point, and it prevented me from getting commissioned. So on graduation day, instead of getting commissioned, I was discharged and came down here for medical school. And as soon as I knew that I was going to be going to medical school, that I was going to be discharged from the Army, I knew that I wanted to work at a VA. I felt a lot of guilt about not being able to give back and to perform that service that I had, you know, spent 4 years planning to do. And I felt like going into work at the VA was an opportunity for me to be able to kind of fulfill that service and to do that. When you first started reading the news about the couple cases of pulmonary illness out in China, it was easy to kind of blow off and say, okay, we'll just kind of keep an eye on it. As January moved forward, started getting more reports and seeing this spreading around the world, you know, there was definitely that sinking moment where I think I went through all seven stages of grief in the course of probably an hour or so, and just kind of recognized that this is going to be an issue for our health system and for our nation.
My name's Carolyn Francis. I'm a nurse here in the ER at the Durham VA Medical Center. I have been a nurse for 8 years, and I've been in this ER for 4. My dad is a Navy veteran. He was in for 27 years, and I just wanted to give back to the community that I was raised in. COVID has changed medicine. COVID has changed nursing. COVID has changed everything, right? Particularly, you know, we went from knowing how to handle situations, knowing through training, through schooling, you know, knowing exactly how to treat a heart attack, to treat a stroke. With COVID, we were in the dark. We had no idea what to do, how to do it, how to keep ourselves protected from it, how to protect our patients, how to treat them. It was the first time, I think, particularly in my career, that we didn't know what we were doing. We were going in blind. But as a team, I think that we've done a pretty good job of being mentally tough and mentally strong. I think that emergency department nurses have to do that anyway. We're tough and we're strong. And, you know, we might joke about it and we might cry about it. You know, it just depends on the day.
It was daunting. I mean, there were the first couple of months, I was in the hospital probably 16, 18 hours a day, 7 days a week. It was like everyone was kind of coming together around that time. You know, we have a health system with 30% of people who are veterans. And I think that really was reflected in how we responded to things. And I think that everyone else, you know, internally, they kind of reflected on the trials and tribulations in their own lives, recognize that big issues like pandemics are kind of a crucible. You know, the fire's hot, but it needs to be in order to forge really strong leaders. And I think that we have a ton of strong leaders here, and they really stepped up and you know, showed their true colors.